Rapids, Ricky Evans. Ricky Evans trifft auf einen der Spieler dieses Jahres 2019. Das Jahr begann für ihn so wunderbar mit dem Halbfinale bei der Weltmeisterschaft im Alexandra Palace. Und dann hat er die UK Open gewinnen können. Die aktuelle 13 der Welt. The Asp, Nathan Aspinall. So, und an dieser Stelle dürfen wir auch den zweiten Caller herzlich begrüßen. Auch ihn kennt ihr durch viele, viele Fernsehübertragungen. Herzlich willkommen, George Noble.
Well, one quarterfinal is set up already here at the International Darts Open. A couple of major champions have booked their place in the final session of action. Daryl Gurney, the Players' Champion, and the three-time Lakeside World Title winner Glenn Durrant will square off in our opening last eight clash of the evening. We now turn our attention to the second quarterfinal in the same half of the draw. Nathan Aspinall, the UK Open winner, and Rapid Ricky Evans, the fastest player on the planet, about to do battle for a spot in the last eight. Nathan has had an incredible year. It was this time last year that he picked up his first PDC title. He's just gone from strength to strength to strength. He has not really done a great deal since returning from the August break, but maybe this is the weekend when things start to click for him ahead of some big tournaments coming up.
First leg, Ricky to throw first. Game one.
The Rapid Ricky Evans is a man who's made a couple of Euro Tour finals. He's still searching for that elusive first PDC title. It could be the biggest weekend of his career. Mark Webster alongside me for this one.
Yeah, fascinating clash coming up. Both players in similar up-down form 60. Since after the World Match Play. I was impressed with Nathan yesterday. First game on against Justin
62.
Pye. Justin threw everything at him, but he responded. We saw Ricky get by Dimitri Vandenberg last night in a game where Ricky punished missed doubles from Dimitri.
100.
Good opportunity for one of these to advance.
Yeah, the finishing was very, very good from Ricky Evans yesterday. Dimitri hit him with a lot of big 59. Scores, but 67% on the doubles saw Ricky win it 6-4. Nathan was very close to the 100 average as he beat Justin Pipe 6-3.
98.
Nathan was saying to me about Remus Day since he's come back from match play. He thinks he's been too nice when he's playing, so he's going to show a bit more aggression.
76.
On that stage.
Yeah, saw a bit of that against Justin. A lot of insects here this weekend in Rita.
I saw one attack Richard North after he'd thrown his last dart last night.
137, Ricky.
Must have been an Ian White fan. Travel 18 would have left the bullseye.
96. Nathan, you require 106.
These two have not met since back in 2016 on the when they played in the Euro Tour, which Ricky won.
74.
And Ricky leads a head-to-head.
Ricky require 68.
Nathan's only victory coming way back in 2014 on the challenge.
He's on the first leg, Ricky Evans. Second leg, Nathan to throw first. Game on.
Yeah, four wins for Ricky Evans out of their five meetings. But Nathan, I mean, he's
60.
It's like he's levelled up over the last year since winning his first title. It's just gone from strength to strength.
100.
And he just looks like one of the best players in the world right now.
Yeah, that run in the world championships to the semi-finals. Yes, the draw opened up, but he opened it up for himself, really, getting rid of Gerwyn Price in the first round. You could argue he breezed to the semi-finals.
59.
Picking up that £100,000, which bumped him up the rankings and then gave him the confidence to go on and win his first major in Minehead in March. He's gone from strength to strength.
81.
Well, Aspinall wants a ton 40 here. Not going to get that.
£42,000.
Significantly short of it. And that might be a leg-changing visit because rapid Ricky Evans in double quick time leaves himself on a two dart out.
180 the best time this hand when it's done in less than 2 seconds.
98. Ricky requires 62.
And gives Ricky the chance for an early break and to double his lead. This one was his strength yesterday, the doubles. But
46.
So Nathan gets a reprieve.
Nathan, you require 40.
Well, four perfect darts to leave him on a double and then missing with two. Aspinall to punish. Double five
he's
is there.
On the second leg, Nathan Aspinall. Third leg, Ricky to throw first.
Again, another 180 for Ricky Evans. Double quick time.
Did make the quarterfinals in Austria, Ricky Evans. He was knocked out at this stage in Mannheim. So
97.
Even though he went out in round one of both of the Pro Tour events midweek. $8,000 for
132.
Bad going. Better than working it down the local petrol garage, which is what he did for a significant portion of time, Ricky Evans.
He's
definitely stepped it up this year, Ricky Evans. Credit to him becoming a seed on the Eurotour courtesy.
59.
All those two runs to finals, losing out to Ian White at the back end of last year, and Daryl Gurney in the first European Tour of the year. Only seen Nathan Aspinall once on the last session of the Euro Tour this year.
Easy, we give 130.
Back-to-back maximums from Nathan Aspinall. Does 90. Get him a chance.
Nathan, you require 44.
An early break for Nathan.
12.
They went, good darts,
Ricky,
double
you
16.
Require 40.
So well to carve out the opportunity. Up for double five.
30.
Chasing doubles around the ball, Ricky Evans.
Nathan, you require 32.
So another goal for the Asp.
Oh, great scoring from these two. The finishing's not as convincing, though, is it? Last start in hand, double four. And Nathan Aspinall for the second
Nathan
leg
Aspinall.
Running pins a double last dart after chasing him around
Nathan
the board.
To throw first.
Goes into the lead.
And Nathan securing that leg on his fifth dart at a double, and it was the only one. It was really well thrown. A bit weight with the other four, but he gets the break.
60. $81.
Winner of this faces either Joe Mernon, unseeded player, the only unseeded player left in this half of the draw, or the defending champion Gerwyn Price. It could be a repeat of Nathan Aspinall's World Championship clash with the Iceman, which was very entertaining.
And they clashed in the semi-finals at Minehead as well.
Yes, they did. Yes, well. An absolute thriller there.
So Nathan coming out on top on both occasions.
4 180s for Nathan Aspinall in four
60.
Legs.
Nathan, you require 121.
Not bad from the Asp. Treble 20 for double 18.
105.
Quite a Dutch way of going about things for the 1-2-1. Use of the bullseye.
24.
Dutch influence over the last few
16.
Years. It's a better dart at double eight, but it still didn't find it.
He's on a full flag.
Same time as last time. He takes off
the
four again.
Throw first.
Open up a two-leg gap.
134.
Good quality from Nathan Aspinall, because Ricky did have those chances to break Nathan's throw.
Yeah, missed a couple of darts in the second leg, missed four darts in the third leg. Ricky Evans. His scoreline could be flipped.
135.
But Nathan's got his range on that treble 20.
134.
Again in this leg. Nathan will be sensitive if he can clinch that double break.
16.
Well on his way to the quarterfinals tonight.
96.
Beautiful stuff.
135.
Ricky
with 137.
Does leave him a finish.
57. Nathan Urquhart, 167.
A real good setup shot. Gonna go. But you feel the 80 has to go for Ricky Evans.
60.
And the finishing's not been convincing 80. So far. Only gonna get one dart at double top.
60.
And some way off
Nathan
again.
Nathan Urquhart, 107.
His last dart was lower than the second dart, but he never really. Near double top for a double break, double 16.
75. Ricky Urquhart 20.
Got to go, Ricky Evans.
He's on the fifth leg. Ricky Evans.
Back within one.
Sixth leg. Nathan to throw first. Game on.
Well, Ricky always felt, or you always felt that Ricky was chasing the game against Dimitri Vandenberg. He felt he was hanging on because Dimitri. Seen the aggressor, he was firing in so many big scores against him, and Ricky's finishing kept him in the game, and eventually when he got his chance he seized it late on in that match. Here he has missed some opportunities, and Nathan's scoring looks set to give him plenty of chances to win legs.
Ricky's just got to tell himself he hung about in the early exchanges against Dimitri Vandenberg. And the chance came, one break a throw.
100.
It's all that separates him at the minute, so he's just got to keep digging in. Hope chances come on the Aspen
99,
throw,
Nathan Urquhart, 84.
Nathan keeps this up, 9 darts thrown, 84. It'll be an 11 dart, a double 12. Great guide. And he uses that guide brilliantly.
7 leg Ricky to throw first.
This is impressive stuff from Nathan Aspinall.
58.
And it's the sort of stuff he's produced on a number of occasions this year. He was averaging just over 99 against Justin Pipe. He's in the same sort of ballpark here.
97.
Just looks like he's got a bit too much firepower for Ricky Evans. And that's underlined by that first nine average. Although that'll help Rapid Ricky.
180.
Start, so like we said, if he can just stick in there.
Oh, hitting straight back with one. Straight back at him.
Response from the Asp.
57.
Bombarding Ricky Evans at the minute. Forcing errors.
57.
Oh, this is the sort of stuff that darts fans and punters who've been lumping on Nathan Aspinall to win the world championship, this is the sort of stuff that's convinced them that he could win the biggest prize in the sport, Ali Pali, this Christmas.
102.
I like this
interview after he won
the US Masters. A lot of people think that he'd just come in to enjoy himself in Las Vegas.
He's on the seventh leg. Nathan to throw first. Game on.
Decent leg of darts from Rapid Ricky. 14 darter. Cuts that gap to one. He's still in this game.
100.
He is hanging about. I mean, he's been as much as 10 points away from Nathan Aspinall in the averages, but he's just been
97.
Nicking legs under pressure. And I tell you what, those two legs early on in the game when he missed darts to win them and lost those legs, it could have been very different this game.
60.
He's just hanging in there. He's only one break of throw behind, and if he can claw that break back,
100.
Kirsiev winning the ball, he'd have the darts to go on and win the match. And chasing the match.
100.
Comes the game, Ricky. If he can win this leg, you'd have to argue he becomes the favourite.
97.
Well, whose shoes would you rather be in this leg? Maybe Nathan's now. Certainly Nathan's now. 6 180s for the Asp, and that one is a crucial one.
135. Nathan, you require 61.
Nathan will be aware, Ricky's far behind. And there's always the risk of going that route. Double four. We've seen him hit on two occasions already, even not this time.
Ricky requires 72.
There's a chance, we said.
Took out 72 in the last leg. Double 18 works for him this time. A brace of 72 checkouts, two different routes, but the same outcome in both. Ricky Evans breaks. And is he now the favourite for this one? Nathan Aspinall is averaging 101. But unless he can break the Evans throw, he's going out of the tournament before the quarterfinals.
97.
Ricky Evans, he knew which way he was going. It was treble 20 for double six. If he missed, straight to the 16. It converts opportunity. And hammered it home, the advantage in this leg.
10 180s in this contest.
100.
Oh, superb stuff, Ricky Evans, to get the break and then be on a potential 11 darter on your throw.
96, Ricky Evans.
Leave himself the 170. Ricky Evans has got time on his hands. Doesn't need time, Ricky Evans. Needs less time than anybody in the world.
Throw first. Game on.
The blink of an eye from 4-3 down. Ricky finds himself 5-4. And on the verge. Moving on into the quarterfinals.
140.
Three legs in 40 darts.
100.
Great contest. 10 180s. Both averaging around that 100 mark. Make it 11 180s, Nate.
140.
This 60. Might be going the distance. Five times they've met, four times Ricky Evans has won. It is 100. 3 years since their last meeting. That one did go to a last leg decider. That one was won by rapid Ricky Evans.
93, maybe you recall 121.
Ricky knows he's well behind the missed leg, but he's got the insurance, he's got the darts. In the last leg, if he needs him.
37.
Slight chance for the turn 40 for Ricky. 84 is no gimme for Nathan.
Oh.
95.
Not quite. He does get Nathan to a finish. But it's not as easy as it might have been. Aspinall has taken out this 84 once already in the game. Looked decisive when he went 4-2 up.
He's on a 10th leg. Nathan Aspinall.
84 finish again. 11th and final leg.
Ricky to Rover.
Shoots out between the players.
Game on.
But it's Ricky Evans who's got the darts.
59.
It's been high quality stuff for 10 legs here. The result still hangs in the balance. Nathan Aspinall. What a start.
140.
Taking that after the 59 visit of Ricky Evans to open.
100.
Another 10-40 from Nathan now will give him firm control of his deciding leg. Third dart.
40.
Floor in this match, and I think that one really bounced. He just caught the flight on his own dart.
45.
You could have made a case for switching away to a different target there after blocking a bit of the bed. Nathan Aspinall's not moving anywhere from there.
140.
Advantage, the Asp. Needs to fill it up.
99.
Not on earth. Nathan Aspinall. A 6 starts, get rid of 181. Move it to 25 or treble 15.
127.
Nathan Aspinall should get a couple of match darts for just his second win against Ricky Evans. He is only hitting 1 in 3 of his darts at double, though. Are 2 match darts enough? No, they are not. And rapid Ricky Evans, a spot in the quarterfinals, is within his grasp.
Treble 20, 2 darts, double 19. Looks awkward, moves over.
79.
Too high, so Nathan again.
Nathan, you require
more chances 10. To advance into tonight's final session.
Loads of big scores in this game, but we have seen missed doubles. 3 more means that the Asp might be going home.
Ricky, you require 19.
He just steady himself. 3 for double 8. Double 1.
17.
How much of that was about missing the 3? Yes, he'd erred on the side of caution, not going the 19 10. Side of it. But he did not want to be throwing it double 1 there. 4 match darts missed. Nathan Aspinall, so good for so long in this game. And game. Somehow so, crawls and over the line. Rapid Ricky Evans misses 4 match darts. Nathan Aspinall books his place in the quarterfinals. It was brilliant for 10.5 legs. And then all got a bit nervy. The relief on Nathan Aspinall's face tells a story. But the UK Open champion makes it 3 major winners in our quarterfinals tonight so far. He will take on either Joe Mernon or the man he beat at the Worlds and the UK Open, the defending champion here at the International Darts Open, the Iceman Gerwyn Price.
Was für ein verrücktes letztes Leck in dieser Partie. Matchstarts für beide und der Sieger heißt am Ende Nathan Aspinall. Also Applaus für Rapid Ricky Evans. Congratulations. Still shaky, right?
Oh, wow. That was a good game, and at the end, very nervy. But I think that's the first time I beat Ricky. He's a quality player, and I played well yesterday, and that was a great game. But at the end, oh, God, you know, we both had our chances, and, you know, luckily I shook the dart in. I don't even know it went in, to be fair. It was like, but it went in, and, you know, I'm really happy to win.
What's actually in your mind, in your head, in a situation like that? What are you thinking in this situation?
You know, I kicked off well in that last leg, and I got the opportunity, and then when I missed it, I'm thinking, well, when I come back, do I go 2-4, do I go for it again? And luckily for me, at the big 17, double 1's a lot harder than double 8. But you could just please have a bit of luck, you know, because you need luck in darts, and I do think I got a bit of luck there at the end because I had my eyes shut and it went in, so happy days.
See you later again. Thank you very much. Nathan Aspinall. Ist froh, dass da durchgekommen ist, was für eine Situation. Hat gestern verdammt gut gespielt und